First, let's look at the case of normal incidence. In this case, the normal vector to the plane of the boundary is parallel to the k vector of the incident wave. Or in other words, the wave is propagating straight toward the boundary. When the wave actually hits the boundary, the energy can do one of two things. Either it can pass through into the second medium and keep traveling, or it can reflect off the boundary and propagate backward into the first medium. As it turns out, most cases will result in part of the wave being transmitted into the second medium and part of the wave being reflected. In order to figure out how much of the energy follows each of these paths, we'll have to apply boundary conditions. From our study of static fields, we have these useful relationships. These relate the tangential and normal components of the electric and magnetic fields in the first medium to the tangential and normal components of the electric and magnetic fields in the second medium. Note that since we have normal incidence, both the electric and the magnetic fields of the incident wave are perfectly tangential to the boundary. Therefore, these are the relevant boundary conditions for this scenario. Let's consider this one first. The tangential electric field is the same on both sides of the boundary. This is talking about the total electric field. So in the first medium, the total electric field is the sum of the incident wave and the reflected wave. In the second medium, the total electric field is just the transmitted field. So we can rewrite this equation like this. Note that we're using the propagation constant gamma 1, corresponding to the material properties of region 1, for the fields on the left side of the equation, and gamma 2, corresponding to the material properties of region 2, for the fields on the right side of the equation. Similarly, for this boundary condition, the total magnetic field in region 1 is the sum of the incident and reflected magnetic fields, and the total magnetic field in region 2 is just the transmitted wave. So we can rewrite this equation like this. Note that we have applied our knowledge of TEM waves here to put the magnitude of the magnetic field in terms of the electric field magnitude scaled by the intrinsic impedance of the relevant medium. These two equations can be rearranged to obtain the reflection and transmission coefficients for this normal incidence scenario. The reflection coefficient is defined as the ratio of the magnitude of the reflected electric field to the magnitude of the incident electric field, and it works out to eta 2 minus eta 1 over eta 2 plus eta 1. Similarly, the transmission coefficient is defined as the ratio of the magnitude of the transmitted electric field to the magnitude of the incident electric field, and that works out to this ratio, 2 eta 2 over eta 2 plus eta 1.